Hi guys, here's me applying two new poly gel nails. I prep the nail by pushing back the cuticle and then filing it so that there's no shine. I use the Kiss nail glue and I apply fake tips. Again, this part is optional, but I like it better. It makes my nails more sturdy. I'm using the Macart poly gel nail kit in the color dark pink. I use rubbing alcohol as the slip solution. Make sure you're not using too much rubbing alcohol because it will make the nail rise and bubble when you're trying to apply it. Here I am applying a base coat and then curing it. Now I apply the dual form that has the poly gel in it, and you just press it on and it will form around the fake tip instead of having to shape the underneath by yourself without a fake tip. Cure it again and they pop right off. Sometimes they come out a little messy, so I have to use the electric file. Then you just buffer the nail, you add a top coat, and cure it again, and you're all.
This is why you should be extremely careful when someone offers to buy you a drink. I went to a punk show in LA with my brother and his best friend. The band I wanted to see wasn't playing yet, so I hit the bar to go grab a drink. That's when this really cute guy approached me and started talking to me. We got to talking and we were vibing for a while. After about 30 minutes, he asked if I wanted to get a beer, and I said sure. I watched him buy it and open it right in front of me. He said he was getting hot and asked if I wanted to go outside and get some air with him. I politely said no because I didn't know if they would let us back in, but he kept insisting. At this point, I had drank half my beer and I was ready to go meet back up with my brother. I let him know and I got up, but that's when I started feeling really weird. As I was looking for my brother, I started to get really dizzy. That's when I felt someone's hand on my shoulder. I clumsily whipped around to check and it was the guy from the bar. That's when he said, "I told you we need to get some air. Let's go to my car." At this point, my body felt so weak, I could barely stand. It was hard to think, let alone reply. That's when he put his arm under my shoulder and was carrying me towards the exit. As we were getting closer to the exit, a deep panic started to set in my stomach. I couldn't talk or walk, but I could still see and hear everything around me. Right before we reached the exit, something amazing happened. Part 2 of why you should be extremely careful when someone offers to buy you a drink. At this moment, I felt like the unluckiest, but also the luckiest person in the world. A group of girls noticed that I was barely able to walk and this guy was practically dragging me out towards the exit. One of them walked over and asked what was going on. The others followed. That's when he said that we were friends and that I drank too much and he was giving me a ride home. The girls looked over to me and asked me if he was my friend. At this point, I couldn't even respond. I couldn't even form words to tell them no. Again, he insisted that everything is fine and he's trying to take me home, but the girls were not having it. They said that since I wasn't responding, they wouldn't let him take me. That's when he tried to push past them, but they stopped him and told him if he does it again, they're going to have to fight him. Luckily, my brother and his best friend had been looking for me and they saw what was going on. The group of girls told my brother everything that was happening. My brother told the girls to watch me, and him and his friend dragged the guy outside instead. My brother taught him a lesson that he'll never forget outside and then came back for me. Since we were 30 blocks from home and I couldn't walk, my brother and his friend put me in a shopping cart and took me home. We never got to see the man that we went there for, but I made it home safe and that's all that matters.
Put your head on my shoulder.
Took advantage of my blindness. We go back and forth a few times. I'm positive that I gave her the right amount, really counting it back to her, and she's like, no, you're wrong. And at this point, more people are walking into the salon, so I'm getting really uncomfortable. Back at it, I should have pulled out my phone that has a money reader on it and read her the money using my screen reader, but I was super uncomfortable and more people were walking in and I just wanted to leave it at that. My sister was paying somewhere else. I had no idea where she was and I didn't want to call out to her or anything. So when we got home, I wanted to double check that these people were actually scamming me. My sister helped me look at the money, and aside from the amount I paid for my nails, obviously, and the tip, I was missing $20. We can learn something from most situations, and this situation just taught me to not carry around cash. I never went to that nail salon again. I actually got my nails somewhere else today, and I think they look pretty good. I mean, I can't see them, but let me know.
You on my team.
So does everybody else. You ain't even here to party. Ken in the club trying to pipe a bar. Listen up, bitch.
When people ask why I send free nails to influencers,
yeah, certain man in Russia.
Ombre Christian Dior decals.
Just one second to make up more time on my hand than hours in the day.
Put Hello. Your head
hey, on girl, what my shoulder.
If you see this, it's a sign to let your nail tech freestyle on you.
One thing I'ma live by is that I will never stick to one aesthetic.
I got some of this, some of that, some of that, you know she cleans up nice. Call me, beat me, if you're trying to reach me.
We can't forget the drip, the drip!
My biggest flex is I'm finally my own nail tech.
You asked for it. You wanted a picture of these nails.
Nothing like a fresh money.
Here are my new nails. Okay, bye.
I got this shit from the king.
Hey ladies, hey ladies. Yo, pussy ride like a Mercedes.
More gel accepts.
He just picked me up.
First set. Nail prep my fob. Second set. Perf application. Last set. Thanks for watching.
Hey, I have a joke for you. Why did Sally fall off the swing?
I don't know why.
Because, well, she had no arms. Knock, knock. Who's there?
Not Sally.
Oh my god, this poor girl. Now, why did Billy drop his ice cream?
Why?
Because he got hit by a car.
But that's not even funny.
Why did the car hit him?
I don't know. Why?
Because Sally was driving.
Okay, that's enough.
Wait, one more. Where did Sally go during the explosion?
Where?
Everywhere.
This is the best part about removing Biab. I miss doing clients' nails. Can't wait to get back to work. My boyfriend goes back to work tomorrow, has been a good hand model, or he's such a good egg. He's actually got better nail beds than me. In gel.
Mess up your IT. I'll do you dirty, yeah.
Tiene una amiga problemática y otra que casi ni habla, pero las tres son una diabla. Y ahí se puso mini falta. Los Phillies en los Louis Vuitton los guarda. Y me dice papi.
Excuse me, who are you wearing?
ASOS, ASOS.
I want that. Love it. Love it. I love it. Fabulous. I think I saw it on ASOS. Love it.
or take on the nail cake.
Sugar, spice, and everything nice. These were the ingredients chosen to create the perfect little girl.
Hope you guys liked this video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. It does help support us, and let's know what videos you guys want to see.